الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد قال الله تعالى في الكتاب المجيد فرقان الحميد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل إن المنافقين في الدرك الأسفل صدق الله العظيم بنسيس الإسلام السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته I'm going to paraphrase the Arabic portion of Khutbah. Indeed, all praises to God Almighty. We praise Him, we ask for help, we seek refuge in Him from our inner soul, from our bad deeds. Whomsoever God Almighty guides, no one can stray. Whomsoever He does not guide, no one can guide. I bear witness, no one is worthy of worship except God Almighty alone. Muhammad His servant, messenger, peace and blessing upon him and his followers. O believers, ever conscious awareness of God Almighty, die not except total submission to God Almighty. O mankind, have a conscious awareness of God Almighty. He has created you from a single soul. From that soul He made many pairs. Especially be dutiful to those whom you have mutual rights. Indeed, God is all watching. For believers have a conscious awareness of God, speak nothing but truth, so He can rectify your deeds, He can forgive your sins, best among you is follow God Almighty and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam sunnah. That was the Arabic portion of the khutbah. For today's khutbah, I have chosen an ayah, part of ayah from Surah Al-Nisa, Surah number 4, verse number 145. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي ذَلْكِ أَسْفَلِ. Indeed, the munafiq, the hypocrites at the bottom pit of hellfire. I have chosen this ayah because this is my first khutbah in this masjid in 2018. Many times people say, what's your resolution for the New Year's? You know, for us as a Muslim, these are the things that we hear. But you know, Mother's Day, Happy New Year's Day, Happy you know, Father's Day, Happy Secretary Day, Happy Paralegal Day, Happy Valentine, Happy New Year. You will hear this because we're part of this culture, this society. And we're living here by choice. So we need to understand where do we stand with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and where do we stand with the culture. So we cannot have extreme position either way. But we have to have a very straightforward relationship with God Almighty. And when we come across with the people, those who are different faith, different religion, different culture, we also be held liable how we relate and how do we deal with those people. So if somebody say Happy New Year to you, you shouldn't be panicking. That's a good time to have a conversation. Brother or sister, should I celebrate or should I reflect what I have done? I'm closer to death. So this is for you is happy year, for me is happy year, but let's have a reflection. For us, what's the resolution for New Year? We all made the resolution with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah recorded in Surah Iraq, Surah number 7, verse 175. Alastubiku Rabbi, do you know I'm your Rabb? Before we came here with Allah, Spirit, Allah created every single one of us and asked, do you know I'm your Rabb, I'm your sustainer? And Kalu Bala, every one of us said, yes, indeed, Kalu Bala. So we already made a resolution. We already made a commitment that yes, you are the God Almighty, you are the sustainer. Yes, whatever we do in this world, we're doing to please you. And that's what our ultimate goal is. So we cannot celebrate one day, a Mother's Day, to just give flower and 364 days we ignore it. It doesn't work like that. We don't thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala only one day or 1 hour with the turkey and Thanksgiving. No. Each time we breathe, Alhamdulillah. We breathe out, Alhamdulillah. We breathe in, Alhamdulillah. We see the parent wa bil walidayni ihsana. We see somebody who's subordinate. If you don't have mercy, those who are under you and subordinate, you know Allah have no mercy on you. If you don't have respect for the children, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, Walaysa minna, he's not from us. So all religion is a package deal. These are minor small thing in and out. But we shouldn't be panicking. Somebody says, oh, Safra brother, you should say Happy New Year. Or you shouldn't get involved. Brother and sister, the best example for us is not the Shaykh, not the Khatib, not the Imam, not the Faqih, not the Alam from Al-Azhar, not the Alam from Medina. We have the best example, the Shaykh of all Shuyukh, Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Why? Because we start understanding the deen from bottom up. This khatib, then Imam Masjid, then local, and then Imam Awanifa, Imam Malik, Imam Ahmad, and then Sahaba, then so on and so forth, and then we get to Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. By the time you get there, you're lost, have it. It should be the other way around. Quran, Sunnah, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Ijma' companion of Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So when Allah says the deen is complete, trust me, it is complete. But we're looking at the wrong compartment, we're looking at the wrong places, and we get lost. So when you talk about how to deal with other people, how to deal with these holidays, how to deal with the rituals, we have youngsters here, Alhamdulillah, we confuse the heck out of them. It's haram, it's bid'ah, it's kufr. Really? That's it is, then pack up and leave. There is no enforcement, for us. This is the hijrah. There is no hijrah for us. You chose this country with your own will. A matter of fact, check your embassy today and Google it and see how long the line that you have to come to America and look at the line that have you from your country going for Hajj and Umrah. So let's be open and let's live in this country as a true practical Muslim, a Muslim of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's companion. So Allah has put us in a situation where the companion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam were. They were minority, we are a minority. They were not making day-to-day decisions, we are not making day-to-day decisions. The kuffar were making decisions for their life, kuffar are making decisions for our life. We are a minority, we are on run, we've been defamed, we've been denigrated. They were on run, they were defamed, they were denigrated. They were nobody, they were not trusted in the community. We were nobody, we were not trusted in the community. The media was covering them everywhere. There was talk of the town. We are covered in the media in a bad way. We are talk of the town. We are living exact same life of Sahaba. Allahu Akbar, we are blessed. But if we understand how if they turn things around from there, we have to let this hypocrisy go. That's why the ayah says the worst pit of Jahannam. Think of this as ocean, but it's full of fire, and you just dive in, you're going to die as soon as you touch it, but you're at the bottom pit of it. So somehow if you manage to come up, it's too late. So Allah says in the Quran, the munafiq are the worst and bottom pit of hellfire. We all, as a reminder first of all for myself and all of us, we Muslims are living a life of hypocrites. Life of hypocrites. What is a hypocrite? Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that. We have a definition. What is a hypocrite? Three things. Whenever they promise, he lies. Whenever you trust with something, betrays trust. Right? And whenever he promise, he breaks promise. And whenever he speaks, speaks lie. It's a hadda sa kazab. It's a wada akhlafa. It's a tum in a khan. Simple thing, right? Look at yourself. Today we don't have gold, we don't have bag, we don't have camel to say, okay, this is a trust for you, I'm going to go for Hajj, when I come back I'll get it from you. No. Today the trust is the worst, there's a different definition. You are a teacher in this school, are you teaching? You are a khatib, did you do research before you step on member of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Did you do research from Quran and Sunnah? Or did you do research from Hanbali, Maliki, Shafi, Ahmadi, Al-Sunnah, Muqallad, Ghair Muqallad, Jamaat Islami, Itna, Isna, Allahu Akbar? Or did you go through Quran and Sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Allah bless all those Muslim scholars, those who passed away. Ameen summa, ameen, Allah give them Jannah for those. And those who are alive, Allah guide them. Those who are coming after us, may Allah make sadqa jariya. We shouldn't have beef with anybody. But this is a poison coming from the member of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the amana, this is the trust given to you. Your board of trustee, your chairperson, your cab driver, your doctor, your engineer. What are you doing? Look at yourself, brother, sister. This is a reminder for you, a reminder for myself. Do you do what you're supposed to do? When you promise and say, can you please meet me today at 2 o'clock? In your heart, you know that you're not going to make it because your commitment is somewhere else. And you know you're not going to do it. You need to ask your spouse. But it's inshallah, ta'ala, inshallah. Really? You're using Allah's name just to shut the person off? Oh, inshallah, ta'ala, I see you, inshallah, ta'ala. In your heart, you know you're not going to see it. In your heart, you know you're not going to make it. Because you already have a commitment somewhere else, but you just want to get out of here for now. Inna Allah alimu bi zaati sudur. Allah looks at your heart. He knows where you are. So what is a munafiq? What is a hypocrite? Anytime you have two thoughts, two things are going on in your heart. You promise you're saying something else, but you're doing something else, and you have intention somewhere else. Look at Muslim Ummah from Allah has blessed us in the world and hereafter as well, that we are given a deen, a guidance. We started with Adam and ended with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have the guidance of deen. Inna deen and Allah al-Islam. Muhammad being the last messenger, Quran being the last messenger, Allahu Akbar, we're blessed. Look at the dunya. 77% of world commodity, the one of the best commodity, the people killed each other and the still recent wars are going on that commodity which is called oil. 77% is under control of Muslim Ummah. And while you and I are speaking here, by the time we finish this khutbah, next 10 minutes, somewhere a Muslim already dying at the name of Islam. Both sides saying, Allahu Akbar, Takbir. What are we doing? We can talk about politics, we can talk about religion all day long. Do we talk about ourselves? Do I understand who I am? Ala nafsi basira, you know where you stand. You know who you are. But you would be worried about Palestine. You would worry about Kashmir. You would worry about Chechnya. You would worry about Israel. You would worry about Palestine. You would worry about Egypt, Pakistan. Allahu Akbar, that's good. But brother, you worry about your own house here. You worry about your own family here. You worry about your own neighbor here. You worry about your own masjid here. And we sit in seclusion, and what do we talk? From today onward, pay attention. We sit 2 hour, 3 hour, international politics. Brother, are you running? Do you have that responsibility? Can you make any change? So what the heck have we been doing? I'm talking about somebody who's not present. And what we're talking, nobody likes it, right? So that's what called Ghiba. That's what we've been doing for 2 hours. What's the purpose? What's the logic? We live double life, brother and sister. We need to cut it down. And that is the biggest disease that we have. One of the biggest issues that we have nowadays in American society is the domestic violence among cops. Police families. Police abuse their wife. Cop abuses his wife. Where is she going to go for a report? To another cop, right? You go to the police station, the cop not going to write it. Unless they come tomorrow, day after tomorrow, whatever it is. Another issue is going on, not in every single khatib or every single scholar, Allah bless them, among the leader of Islam. Ask the spouse of a khatib or imam how he is at home, how he is in his community. Yes, it looks beautiful. Yes, I can memorize Al-Quran. Yes, I can spit it back. Question is that, how do I act upon it? You don't know me, I don't know you. Ask my spouse, ask my children, ask the people that I live with. That's called hypocrite life, that's called double life. And that's what we all are prone to do in our own individual life. But the responsibility is that those who have more knowledge may be more accountable. And alhamdulillah, we all have enough knowledge what's right or wrong. So stop confusing our youth in the future. So coming back, the Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best example. Let's look at his example. In Surah Luqman, I believe Surah number 31. Inna shirka la zulmun azim. One of the biggest sin in Islam is shirk. What is shirk? Association with Allah. Allah is son and daughter. We don't believe that anymore. Why? Because Quran says, Qul huwa Allahu ahad, Allahu samad. Lam yalid wa lam yulad wa lam yakul lahu kufuwan ahad. Done deal. But Prophet said, Muslim will still do shirk. How? Because they will delegate the duty of Allah to somebody else. Association with Allah. Allah's authority, somebody else is doing it. But let me give you an example. One of the worst thing practical shirk is the idols, right? Statues. Worshipping, right? But let me ask you this question. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in Makkah. How long? Does anybody know? 13 years, right? And then he was forced to move to Medina. Didn't Muhammad pray in Makkah? If you're Ahlul Sunnah or Ahlul Shia, it doesn't matter who you are. It's authentic, yes, he did pray. An authentic narration of both school of thought is that Muhammad is praying and somebody brought a dead animal on top of him and he could get up and search it. And one narration of Abu Bakr came, one narration of Fatima came to rescue him, right? Remember that? So what's the purpose of these folks' stories? Half an hour, chill out, you know, lunch break, go home. Purpose is to reflect. أَفَلَا يَتَطَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ Surah Al-Nisa. When you're going to ponder about this book? When you're going to pay attention? If you just here to listen to me, I think it's been recorded. Give us an email, we'll forward to you, it'll be easy. Come here, meet each other, find out, greet each other. What happened to you, brother? What happened to you, sister? How's your house? How's your mother? How's your foreclosure? Do you need any help? What's going on in the community? How's your children? They get married, they graduate. Allahu Akbar. Yawm al-Jum'ah, get together. No, just come, recitation, and you know, some person come back, listen from here, they're all go. So Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was there 13 years. He prayed there. Where did he pray? In Kaaba. Where in Kaaba? The cube that we have now, right? What was inside the Kaaba? Does anybody know? 360 or 365 different narration, idols, statues. Muhammad, for whom the Quran says in Surah An-Nisa, Surah number 4, verse number 80, وَمَنْ يُطِيعُ رَسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهَ Surah Al-Imran, Surah number 3, verse 31, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهَ Quran, Surah Ejaz, 21, 33 surah, verse number 21. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ. This is the best example. You follow Muhammad, you follow Allah. Oh, Muhammad, people when I come to me, they should follow you. This is the Muhammad praying among where? Statues. For what? For 13 years. For praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to statues. He goes in Medina, establishes states, come back to Makkah, and not a single suicide took place, not a single bullet was shot, no killing took place. This is not part of our tradition. Our tradition is mercy, our tradition is mercy, and when you take the sword, when you take the gun, it is for the purpose of mercy. It's not a purpose of killing. It's purpose of mercy, first the message is given, and the tamam hujja is done, and then it's done. The jihad, whatever, the qital, whatever is done. But the first thing is what? The message. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam come to Medina, Medina state is established, goes back to Kaaba, and then what? Statues are demolished one by one. So the point I'm raising is that somebody says Happy New Year and we just panic. No. Your focus is to make people happy, but your relationship direct with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then what? Whichever atmosphere you live, you're not living worse than that situation, that you have a statue and somebody worshipping the statue as a god. You're not. But if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from their own world, turn things around, and with masala, with hikmah, with the timing, with the patience, and goes back and conquer the same city. But so we don't need to conquer America. Generally, people don't lie here. Politician, different story. Generally, people don't lie here. If people get caught lying, they have consequences. The society itself respects each other. All we need to do is we need to be standing up a good, practical Muslim, and Dawah will spread itself. And once the Dawah spread itself, you're going to have Muslim mayor, you're going to have Muslim governor, you're going to have Muslim president, and that's what it is. Allah wants you to do your effort, the rest is up to Him. So we need to relax. We're not in that situation where we have statues among us and right next to us. No. We're living in the society which is Christian, supposed to be Christian. Ahl al-Book. The Qutab says, the Quran says what? قَالُوا تَعَالُوا إِلَىٰ كَلْمَةِ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ. Oh Muhammad, قُلْ يَا أَحْلَ الْكِتَابِ. Oh Muhammad, tell these people, book, let's talk about things we have encountered. Somebody say Happy New Year. Somebody say, you know, Happy Mother Day. Oh well, thank you so much, but for us, every day is Mother Day. What do you mean by Mother Day? We will celebrate every day. Because you know why? There are 53 Muslim countries, you know, they're bound to the Stone Ages, but you will not find a single nursing home in Muslim country. Why? Because of our responsibility. Wow. Dialogue, discussion. Happy New Year, yes, the New Year times to reflect. What's a New Year? Old New Year is a Hijra. What do you mean Hijra? Is traveling migration. It's part of what? Ibrahim al-Islam. It's part of Isa al-Islam. It's part of Musa al-Islam. Your Torah is full of the Exodus. Isa al-Islam was also a refugee. Moses was also a refugee. Ibrahim was also a refugee. And if you're really Christian, you shouldn't hate a refugee. You know why? Because this is in your book. How can you hate your refugee from Syria? If you really truly, a Christian. Dialogue, discussion, Allah is providing the opportunity. Rabbal haram, don't. This is something we need to, so this hypocrite life, we need to give it up. Be whoever you are, wherever you are, because you do not know you're going to make it home alive or not. Brother, we're living peaceful, we're living really high, there's not going to be any flood here, weather is outside very nice today, I don't think we're going to have anything, maybe earthquake, I don't know. Oh, there's not much chances because we're not in California. Brother, no, don't temper with Allah's law. You're sitting here, there's a firehouse right behind us, right? They might be training a new guy, brake fails, they come through right here. Are you ready to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Is your wasiyah right? Did you write on your debts? If you're giving me shower after my death, am I clean as an adult man? Yes, right now I want to look really cool, mashallah. But after I die, it's up to Allah's mercy in your hand. Am I ready physically? Have you paid your debts? Have you asked people for forgiveness? We remember that when we go for Hajj. We remember that when we go for Umrah. Brother, I'm going for Umrah, I need my wasiyah. Really? So you think you're going to die only over there?
Allah is everywhere. Allah is in your heart. Alhamaha fajuraha wa taqwaha. It's in our heart. So brothers and sisters, we need to give up this life of doubles. For the children, do not lie. Do not lie. For adults, we should not lie at all. But children, don't ever lie. Trust me, your life will change. Your life will be perfect. I don't have much time, but I'll give you an example, inshallah. Quickly, there was a caravan going. And there was a robber was stealing from everybody. And there come a child, and they ask him, do you have anything? He said, yes, I do. They check him up twice, let him go. He said, he doesn't have anything. He comes back, he says, yes, I do have. They check him again, he said, he doesn't have anything. The child comes back, he says, yes, I do have money. I'm telling you. They said, we looked three times, where is money? He said, inside my pocket, my mother sewed here, and she said, when you get to the destination, rip your inside pocket and use the money. I have money inside here. They took him to the leader, the in charge, who was doing all the whole robbery bin. They said, this is what kid's telling us, we need to check. So rip his pocket, they see money in there. The king, the thief, the in charge, saying what? Astaghfirullah, this is enough. A small child, they asked me, why did you do that? I said, my mom told me never lie. Doesn't matter what happened. They said, do you know we'll take your money, you will not have any food? I said, doesn't matter. She said, God provides, doesn't matter what happened to you, never lie, son. So I'm not going to lie. God will provide me. You want to take it? Take it. And that's the time for him to repent. And the entire clan said, you know what? Astaghfirullah. If this child can remember his mother and he does not worry about the consequence of lying, what I'm doing, I'm disobeying Allah's command. From today onward, I will not do any robbery. Give everybody their wealth back and ask for forgiveness. And guess what? That child later on turned out to be one of the greatest Sufi scholar. Among Hanbali school of thought, and Hanfi also take him as a leader. His name is Sheikh Abdul Qadir Jilani. So brother and sister, please, the kids, don't lie. You might have small pain at that time, parent might get iffy, but God is watching. Parent can die today. Parent will die. Trust me, many of you will bury us. But what matters is that you will stand in front of God and your parents will be standing right next to you at that time. And guess what? It's going to be open up. So be open and be candid to parents now. And parents, please don't scare children. Because we have this, you know what? Noman Ali Khan was saying that Muslim reprimation is that, you know, Fatima annoys you and Aisha is standing by you, hit Aisha. But what? I didn't do it. Well, I was upset. Hey, Fatima did something wrong. Well, Muslim father is like, Aisha, you're close by. I don't want to get up. We need to stop, you know, be open, be honest. We don't know how long we're going to live. Love each other, open your heart, open your chest, love Allah's creation. And then inshallah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide us with our conduct. People will come closer to us. And if Allah wants to guide them, they'll accept the deen. Your and my job is not to make everybody Muslim. Our job is to live as a perfect Muslim. Try our best to live as perfect, and Allah will guide us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us wisdom, vision, and strength to adhere to His deen. Give us wisdom and strength. Amin, summa amin, ya Rabbul Alameen. Inna Allah malakat yusallun ala nabi, ya ayyuhal lazeena amunu sallu wa alayhi wa sallimu taslima. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, salat salam ala seyyid al-mursaleen, khatam al-nabiyin, rahmatul alameen, wa alayhi tahirin. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan. Please move up there, brother, stay there. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhaban nar. Rabbana zalamna anfusana wa illam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunanna minal khasirin. Allahumma inna nas'aluka minal khayri kullihi wa na'udhu bika min sharri kullihi. Amin summa amin ya rabbal alamin. Aqimus salam.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح قد قام الإسلام الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله.
Straighten lines, please turn off your cell phone, fill up the gaps. Stop now.
Allahu Akbar. الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواسوا بالحق وتواسوا بالصبر الله أكبر الله سميع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين
آمين
قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله
أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
سبحان
الله أكبر
الله أكبر
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله
السلام عليكم
السلام
الله أكبر
أستغفر الله.